I am Donya, and I'll be giving you a short presentation on the air hostess cabin crew jobs. So there is this quote that talks a lot about what the cabin crew jobs reflect in themselves. It says, for most people, sky is the limit, but for cabin crew, sky becomes their home. If you look at the aviation industry in India, you can see that it contributes about $72 billion to Indian GDP. There are about 464 airports and airstrips, and out of which 125 is owned by the Airport Authority of India. And as per reports in 2018, there were around a little more than 65,000 personnel who were actually employed in the aviation industry, and out of which 14,539 of them were actually cabin crew members. If you look at the different air hostess job roles, the first type would be cabin crew. A cabin crew actually oversees whatever or everything related to passengers, and they involve everything after a passenger has boarded the flight and after takeoff. An air stewardess actually ensures the safety of passengers throughout the flight. Then there are ground staffs. Ground staffs actually help in checking in the passengers, providing any sort of information regarding the flights and any type of queries that a passenger might have. A trainer or a recruiter is another type of job role wherein they have to provide training to the air hostess or cabin crews regarding what all will be the protocols that they have to follow, or what are the security systems that, and emergency procedures that we have to take up, and so on. Then there is the senior flight attendant. The senior flight attendant will demonstrate all these use of safety equipments and emergency equipments in the flight, and they also ensure the safety of passengers. Then there is the crew scheduler. This person will be in charge of arranging a schedule of what all flights and what all timings a crew has to a crew will be scheduled, and what and also for the pilots. Then there is the crew manager. This person will be responsible for all the welfare of the crew members and the members in their airline, like a normal an office manager. Now, coming to the eligibility for air hostess cabin crew, in the educational aspect, they have to be 12th or they have to have a 12th degree or any equivalent diploma or degree with an institute-specified minimum pass percentage. Along with that, they have to be fluent in spoken English and also any other national languages. When you look at the demographic aspect, on trainee entries, it is the age limit would be between 17 to 26. This might vary with respect to organizations. Desirable height would be of 5.5 to 5.9 feet, and this and weight should be in proportion to this height. They should have good eyesight of 20/30 or 20/30 vision or better, and certain airlines also have this policy wherein there should not be any visible tattoos or piercings. Now, coming to the skills required for cabin crew members, the first and most important is the communication and interpersonal skills. Cabin crew will be dealing with people on a very regular basis and on a daily basis with and they are expected to have good interpersonal skills to communicate all the rules and regulations and all the information that has to be passed on. And diplomacy and tact is also a very important skill required here. And this is because cabin crews are actually the face of the airline to the passengers, and they must treat the employee, the passengers in a positive manner, but they should also ensure that everything gets done properly. And in an airline flight, there might be situations where there is emergencies and turbulence. So in such kind of situations, they also should have the ability to remain calm and avoid a panic situation even among the passengers. Then coming to assertive, and another skill would be assertive and positive. This is because if you again look at the emergency situation, they have to remain calm, stay positive, and along with that, they have to make sure that the passengers adhere to whatever rules and regulations have to be followed. So in this situation, they require to be assertive as well. Now, a general average pay scale of the industry. The starting would be around 4,20,000 LPA. Middle level would probably be 6 lakh LPA, and senior level 9 lakh LPA. These are actually industry estimates, and it will vary from organization to organization. Now, come to their main jobs and responsibilities. So the first one would be to conduct pre and post takeoff as well as pre-landing checks. So when you look at the pre-takeoff checks, they have to make sure that the intercommunication system is all fine. The intercommunication system might be the communication mechanism wherein they have to communicate to the cockpit and also to the passengers. They have to make sure it's working fine. Then they have to also make sure that, give a check for the cabin equipment and the doors. And also they have to check the alarm system, the lavatory, and also the galleys. Galleys will be the airline kitchens. And they have to just walk around the cabin and make sure that there is nothing unusual, any unusual smell or anything out of the ordinary as a safety precaution. And also they do ensure that all the tray tables are stored properly, seats are upright, armrests are all down before flights, and so on. And post takeoff, they are expected to check the cabins at regular intervals. And along with that, they also have to check the cockpit in regular intervals. And this is to ensure that the pilots are all fine. They have no other requirements, and they're and health-wise and safety-wise also, they are doing well. Then prior to landing, checks would include making sure that there is no loose items around. All the overhead cabins are closed, and there is no hot liquids with the passengers, which would have been given post meals. And all the garbage must be collected and secured away so that during landing there is no spillage or any sort of accident, minor accident that might arise. And they should always be aware of any mechanical emergencies that might come up. Then another one would be checking the safety equipment, aircraft cleanliness, and any other similar checks. So here they have to ensure that the safety equipment like the life jackets and oxygen masks are all in functioning condition, as well as there is enough quantity for all the passengers. Also, they have to monitor that the cleaning teams have done their checks, and they should go around the cabin to all places that is accessible to a passenger and make sure that everything is fine. They should also check the storage compartments of consumables as well as the first aid compartments. And they should also give a general check for items that should not be in an airplane, like maybe knives or scissors or something of that kind. This will be taken care of by the security and during security check and the ground staff, but they have to be aware of this. And also they should just give a check of the catering equipment that is required. Another important responsibility would be welcoming passengers. And this is important because aviation industry is a completely service-based industry. So the cabin crew will be the face of the airline to the passengers. So here they have to make sure that they welcome passengers with a smile, and they assist them in locating their seats. And if any person is finding any difficulty or there are passengers in wheelchairs, they have to be given extra care. And another important job role would be to brief passengers about the flight rules. Here, the cabin crew is expected to inform who the captain is of the flight, and in the introduction that they have with the passengers. And this is important because that will lay down the line of command and the hierarchy in the flight. And also rules like when they can walk around the cabin and when they have to be seated down with their seatbelts on. And also they are supposed to mention any specific rules like some flights might be non-smoking and non-drinking, but some might be just non-smoking, but drinking is permissible. So all such kind of rules and regulations must also be communicated properly to the passengers by the cabin crew. Then any sort of safety procedures also must be communicated. So herein they will have to mention how to use safety belts, and when is it that you have to use an oxygen mask or a life jacket and how to use it. Also, we have to familiarize the passengers with commands like evacuate, 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 and what has to be done at that particular point of time. Also, there are seating positions, like based on where a person is sitting, they have to know how to be seated in times of heavy turbulences. and the emergency exits also must be shown by the cabin crew. Along with that, in some airlines, like in IndiGo, they have to also give special briefing to passengers who are sitting beside emergency doors on how to operate the door if required. Then it is also their responsibility to attend to the comfort and safety of passengers. Here also they have to ensure that all the safety equipments are available to the passengers, and they should also make sure that all passengers are seated correctly. And this is to ensure that the mass is actually evenly distributed, because the flight is mid-air, and there should not be any difficulties for managing the flight. And also, in case there are any emergencies, they have to make sure that the passengers are comfortable and they are not in a panic situation. They have to make sure to reassure the passengers. And also, this is mainly to make sure that the travel of the passengers is as smooth as possible. Here, they also walk around the cabin before takeoff to ensure that all passengers are wearing their seat belts. So they will walk around the aisle and ensure that each and every passenger knows how to put it on, and they are actually having the seatbelt on. And also, in case where there is a passenger who is traveling with small children, they have to be given special seatbelts, and they also have to be educated on how it has to be used. Another responsibility that they take up is making announcements on behalf of the pilot, and also answering any passenger queries that may arise. So here also, in some airlines, captains do this themselves. In other airlines, the cabin crew will have to take up this responsibility, wherein they will welcome everyone on behalf of the captain and pass on information like what is the height at which they're traveling, the speed at which they're traveling, and what will be the estimated time of arrival at the destination, and any other relevant information that has to be passed on. And they also have to answer any customer queries regarding these. Another job that they perform is serving meals and refreshments to passengers. So here, usually there are airlines where people pre-book their food preference, and in other cases, the cabin crew has to ensure taking their food preference of the passengers who are traveling. They also have to ensure that they have the right amount of food packets before takeoff, and they also have to make sure that everything is within expiry dates, and also the temperature. And this all comes under the service part of the airline experience. Then once the plane has landed, the cabin crew has to make sure that the deplaning process is happening smoothly. So here they have to mention what is the baggage counter number, where they can collect their check-in baggage, and they also have to help any passenger who is facing difficulty with overhead cabin baggage. And also they have to assist mothers who are traveling with very small children. Also, in case of passengers who have requested for wheelchair assistance, that also has to be provided by the cabin crews. They also, as per airline requirements, they might also have to prepare flight reports. Flight reports are actually necessarily documentations on how the flight proceedings were. These have to be filed by the cabin crew, filled and filed by the cabin crew as per what the airline procedure is, protocol is. Now, in case of any emergency situations on board, it can be any medical emergency, or it can be any mechanical emergency or technical emergency, or it can even be a hijacking. In such situations, the cabin crew must be able to identify what is the protocol. They have to be able to handle these emergencies in a calm manner, so that they ensure that the passengers are also not in a panic situation. They have to be assertive with their words and ensure some sort of decorum and in the airplane. And here they have to make sure that they are not overly emotional, but they have to be logical and should be able to think on their feet. Then ensuring health and safety of all passengers on board. Here, in case any situation arises, they have to be able to assess the situation and treat the symptoms. They have to be aware of what all first aid equipments they are having and how to use it. And in case of any emergency or any if required, they should be able to seek any medical assistance from the other passengers or request medical assistance on landing. And as per airline requirements, they are also required to complete any paperwork that has to be filed. They are also responsible to maintain the cabin systems on the aircraft. The cabin systems would include the oxygen supply system or the pressure maintenance system. These are not completely maintained by the cabin crew, but they must be able to look for any obvious defaults in order to take any corrective actions later on. And in case they find any such issues, they must be able to take necessary lines of action. Now, in case of any medical emergency, they must be able to provide the first aid, and they must also be aware of any of the symptoms that any disease might be showing, and they must be able to analyze symptoms as part of the first aid itself, and they should also be able to give proper and accurate advices, and they should completely refrain from giving any incorrect advices, because it might cause any legal obligation or financial obligation on the airline in case something goes wrong. They should also provide relevant information to passengers. So during times of emergencies, in case something has to be communicated to the passengers, they have to be able to communicate it properly, but without creating a panic situation. So herein, they have to show their diplomacy skills. And also in case of any passenger raising some queries, they have to make sure that it is resolved by providing right and correct information. Now, some of the benefits of air hostess cabin crew jobs. Since it is a service industry, the airlines take special care of their staff. And in most airlines, they do provide complimentary benefits like discounts to their family members during flight bookings, or maybe food discounts or transportation arrangements also. And you get to meet a lot of new people. Each day and every day, you'll be meeting people from all walks of life, from different backgrounds and different cultures and different places. So this is actually a very exciting part of the job. Here also, you get to explore new cultures. So this can be twofold. You might be meeting people from various cultural backgrounds, and also you'll be traveling to different places to explore the culture. Now, another benefit would be personal development. So airlines will give trainings to the selected air hostess or cabin crew so that they learn about personal grooming and personality development. So these kind of trainings would generate a confidence in themselves and an overall development of their personality. Another one is that it is a very glamorous job, unlike all the monotonous jobs that people do. You get to travel most of the time, and it is a well-paying job. So it is considered to be a very glamorous job. Along with that, since cabin crews are traveling all the time, so airlines also make sure that you get a luxurious accommodation in any time you have to stop at a place and so on. Now, just a few top recruiting companies. There is Indigo, Air India, Go Air, Singapore Airlines, Delta Airlines, Virgin Atlantic, British Airlines, Qatar Airways, and Emirates. These are just a few top recruiting companies for cabin crew. There are a lot more in the industry right now. And thank you so much for listening to the presentation.